15, Andrew Yadder.
Who said the FA Cup had lost its magic?
Yeah, you're right, so I think fantastic game of football, competed very well by, you know, some great goals and two good teams, and we got that winner in the end.
Yeah, when they came back to 3-3 with 4 minutes to go, were you thinking Braintree Tuesday?
Yeah, no doubt. I think we would have thought that we were heading back to Essex. But I think, you know, it just shows how far this group have come in a short space of time in terms of the character, their belief, and didn't let that setback disappoint them. So, you know, there's a lot of positives come out of those performances, and a lot of, you know, poor things. I mean, the goals we look at and we'll be disappointed. But goals for some excellent goals. But character was immense today, and that was a big plus for me.
Paul Rogers going from the touchline shot, was it?
Yeah, it's a full-back, you know, it's a bit like myself, he used to score from there. But yeah, he was only a minute, so I'm not going to argue, but I think sometimes, you know, you just for a pivotal moment in your season, a bit of luck, and maybe that'd be the case today. But, you know, I'm delighted for the players and the crowd, the football club as a whole, and we look forward to tomorrow's draw.
And surely the most popular goal, maybe the most significant goal, Craig McAllister's first for the club.
Without doubt, I think you know. I think we've all desperately egged him on, and the crowd have been fantastic as a collective group, for individually and collectively. But you know, I think they were sucking that ball in the net, and I think I'm pleased for him, because, you know, as long as I can stand here and tell you what the contribution he's having for this team, and it's very, very pivotal to what we're trying to achieve. But as a striker, and there's a group of players, and as you've seen, you know, the celebration there, I think every player and every sub congratulated him, and I'm delighted, and hopefully this can just be one of many that he gets for the football club.
So who do you want in the first round, Rob?
Well, I think, you know, obviously we want exposure, we want finance, we want everything, don't we? So I suppose one of the big Sheffield sides, or a home tie into the Football League side, I think is what you hope for. But, you know, it's we'll have to wait and see. At least we have a smile on our face eating our roast dinner tomorrow, watching the draw.
And what about Danny Rose's contribution there? He's had this week up at Palace. What can you tell us about that?
Well, I think the club approached us. I thought it was the right thing for the boy. I think he's been excellent since I've been here. They've asked to have a look at him. I thought for him, it was a good thing, and to go and see what it's about at that level, and for the club, Crystal Palace wanted to see him. And now there will be discussions between the clubs, you know, to get some feedback of what they thought. But, you know, I said to Danny today, and when he come back, he's, you know, all he's got to concentrate now is continuing his form for Newport, which I thought he did today, you know, in glimpses. So, you know, as we speak, he's a Newport player, and he continues to do that until, you know, like we said, that the right offer comes from either Crystal Palace or whoever.
So there's been no communication between the clubs since he's come back?
No, there's been no offer. So, you know, I think that Danny had dialogue with Dougie Freeman. You know, I'll speak to Dougie after the weekend. I know that he had things to prepare for today, as I did, and we'll take it from there. But, you know, we haven't had any offer for Danny.
It was a great day, Justin. Thanks.
No, brilliant. Thank you very much.